So 84% of our lives, they say, is spent in buildings or around buildings. It's a very large portion. We do not notice that. But during times like the pandemic, we did. So 84% of our lives, they say, is spent in buildings or around buildings. It's a very large portion. We do not notice that. But during times like the pandemic, we did. And there is an interesting history of the intersection of healthcare, architecture, and design. Even before it was known that microorganisms cause pandemics, there was a theory called miasma theory, which was prevalent, which was a dubious theory, but that was the current theory more than 200 years ago, that pandemics are caused by fumes which come out from the soil. And what was the response which architecture and construction brought to this problem? Thousands and thousands of kilometers of land was paved with flagstones. If you will go to Europe, you will see that entire paving of the soil was done to prevent these fumes from rising. Then came cholera and zoning restrictions it brought, how the buildings will be distanced. Sewer systems were brought because of cholera. Coming closer to when the humanity understood that microorganisms are responsible for pandemics. We saw sleeping porches in Victorian homes. You will see second floor balcony-like structure is jutting out, which is not really seems in its place. Sleeping porches, this was brought by tuberculosis. Because before the antibiotics came, the only way to heal these diseases was air and sunshine. Then powder rooms, which we see at the entry of homes, came because ice and coal were delivered daily by boys to the kitchens. So they used to come from various homes and could not be allowed without some sanitizing and some hand washing, etc. So powder rooms close to the entry of the homes came up. Tuberculosis also brought white tiles, easy to clean, identify the dirt and grime there. And overall, one of the most recent interventions by architects was cupboards, built-in cupboards. Earlier cupboards for clothes were heavy furniture which had to be moved, which was difficult to clean below, etc.